presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to our man, Al, in Homosassa. What's going on, brother?
Isn't it wonderful? I went ahead and invested in your Tiger Dollars, and I went ahead and got the gold report for a year, and also your morning, your call letter and stuff like that. And I got over a 50% return in one day, not counting everything else. But I just want to thank you. Tom's not perfect, but he tells you how to put your stops in, and he keeps your losses small. You can take your small losses, but then all of a sudden you'll be like Babe Ruth, and you'll hit a home run. I mean, a big home run.
Yeah.
And put the money in your pocket.
Okay, I mean, brother. You're awesome, man. Thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't take anything personally. Transform your life. When you refuse to take things personally, avoid many upsets in your life. Your feelings of anger, jealousy, and even sadness will simply disappear if you don't take them personally. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 229, NASDAQ up 9, S&P's up 1. Sideways market out here, folks. Gold contract going down $4.70, trading $18.50 an ounce. You got silver up 2 cents, $25.50 an ounce. Light sweet crude off 23 cents, $52.55 a barrel, notes and bonds. We have the 10-year right now up one tick. The 30-year is down one. The 10 trading at 137.13. The 30's at 169.30 and King Dollar. King Dollar's down at 233 ticks, trading 90.158. The euro is out here at 121. The yen is at 103.64. And the British pound is at 137 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, we got a flat market out here, folks. The S&Ps, if we take a look at the SPY, you're going to see the SPY's trading out here at a price point 384.54. We did hit another all-time high out here this morning. Bottom line, we hit a high of 385.85. NDX 100 did the same thing. I think, let me see, the NDX went to a high too. The NDX, no, the high was yesterday on the NDX. Today we reached 329.76. Yesterday we did a 330, what was that? 330 what? 330.32. After the close out here today, one of the big dogs, I mean, between the next 48 hours, folks, you got some, a lot of action coming into the marketplace between the Federal Reserve, between the equities that are coming out with numbers. We got Microsoft, of course, right after the close out here today. They're going to be looking for big numbers. Right now, Microsoft's at all-time highs. They're looking to do $40.2 billion at the top end. They're looking to make $1.64 earnings. And if we take a look at Microsoft and we put this up, what's going to get intriguing here coming into the close is this. Microsoft's been in this consolidation, you know, powerful consolidation, no doubt. The number to keep your eye on coming into the close is going to be the 232.86. That is the high that's breaking out from. Let's see. Let me get this on a daily. So bring this back. Yeah, there it is there. So, that can't be right. Oh, that's a weekly. Okay, 1 second. Hold it. Daily. Okay, so on a daily, yeah, we're not going to get the juice here on the daily. It's going to be really close, but it doesn't look to me. See, the last time we were up here, You got you had 34 million shares traded. Then you had a failure, and it was a pretty quick failure. I mean, the bottom line is that we were testing 57 million. So 57 million is still the game here, and you're at 29. The last time that we were up here, you know, you tested it, and then, you know, bottom line couldn't handle it. We went from 232, and approximately 3 weeks later, you were at 196. This is the type of consolidation. So we'll see how it shakes out coming into the close. Apple. We take a look at Apple. Apple's going to be coming out with his numbers tomorrow after the close. Apple's trading 143.02. That high there was generated yesterday also at 145. The numbers Apple are looking for are pretty extraordinary. This is Apple's always biggest quarter. They're looking for $103 billion to the top line. That's 90 days taking in $103 billion. Not bad, right? To the bottom line, looking for $1.42. But monster number, man. There's no doubt. Monster number. The Facebook. I believe Facebook is out here, too. That's after the close tomorrow. Facebook right now is trading up 494, trading 282.90. That high is 304. More than likely, let's see how Facebook is shaping up right now. Now, Facebook's in a monster consolidation also. That actually doesn't look like it's going to go make a run for its highs. And I believe we also have Tesla tomorrow. So we take a look at Tesla. Yeah, we have Tesla after the close tomorrow also. Tesla is up $7.05. That high, we're right next to it. So that high was generated yesterday, $900.40. Tesla is going to be looking on their top line. They're going to be looking for $10.3 billion. On their bottom line, they're going to be looking to make $1.01. It's a pretty good jump. You know, this year, when you take a look at Tesla, it's pretty interesting quarter by quarter. First quarter, they made 22 cents. Next quarter, 43. Next quarter, 76. And this quarter here, $1.01. They got the growth numbers, no doubt about that. We'll see how the rest of this shakes out. Some of the higher volume equities out here, let's take a look at that because, well, here, no notes and bonds. Notes and bonds tomorrow, folks, you're going to get some big action. You know, my take is that they're going higher price, lower yield. We had the 137.10 bottom line, got back inside its higher range. And not only back inside its higher range, this thing looks to me like you're building cars to get up into this 139 area. Right now, you're at 137.12. Now, the 30-year needs another point. 30-year right now is a point lower than to get in its higher trading range. That being said, though, same setup. I mean, this looks like a nice little bottom's been made here. And if that's what you get, you're going to have the Fed come out. And I think tomorrow all the Fed has to do is status quo. And I can't see them saying anything else, meaning about they're going to be basically pulling back. They've told the market a dozen times, including about 7 or 8 days ago, and then 2 weeks ago prior to that, when the bond and note market was going down, that, hey, they're going to continue buying $120 billion worth of bonds a month. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN, and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I'll personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. We have the Dow. Dow Industrials right now up 38. You get the NASDAQ up 19. S&Ps are up 2.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also, it's a great newsletter, The Opening Call. Now, it's very easy to get his newsletter, folks. You come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to hit newsletters. You're going to see the opening call right on the left-hand side. You just hit subscribe. You can get Basil's newsletter for 1 month for $149. You can get it for 6 months for $695, which is a savings of $199 or 22%. You can get it for 1 year, folks, for $1,195, which is a savings of $593 or 33%. Now, when you get it, folks, Basil has done many workshops, okay? So if you want to learn how to ride the wave, ride that Chapman wave, it's very easy to do. He's got about 9 workshops in there. You want to do some work over the weekend. You want to do some work at night. You subscribe. All the workshops are right there. Great education. Great newsletter. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing good. I heard you got a little chilly up there, though, right?
It did get a little chilly. We deserve it by now. I mean, this is we're well into January.
That's
so
right.
You got to expect, you know, it's funny, at this particular point, even though the worst part of the winter is still to come, I feel like spring is just around the corner.
It is. Well, you know what's interesting, folks, is that what Basil says, so picture, it's the 25th out here today. February is always the worst, but that's only 6 weeks. So, but it can be brutal. There's no doubt, man. Because we're kids, folks, we'd always love the February vacation because there's plenty of snow. You're freezing. You're running around in it. You know, you got it all.
That's right. So I thought what we'd look at here is we're looking at the Dow as always. On the left is my daily Dow chart. In the middle is the weekly. On the right is the monthly. You can see I got a question mark there because from everything I'm looking at, I would not be surprised if February turns into a red candle, but it doesn't have to. I mean, that's not to say it has to crash. It just says there's a chance that we could take a breather. We're well worth it. If I had to show you the monthly chart right now of the S&P, look at this. This is only in leg B. Look at this incredible move from 2191. That's March of 2020. We've made we haven't even made the second peak. We've made one peak, and this is still leg B. And we hit an all-time high today of 38.70. So just in time alone, I think we're getting close to some kind of a breather. And we've taken some precaution because we have just so many longs in my newsletter. And hopefully we can protect them in some way, because many of them are doing really well. You know, we've had stocks that have gone from 3D systems from the 8s to 36. We've had quite a lot of good stocks. So I thought what I'd do is this. I just wanted to show one thing here, and that is the pattern that I'm looking at in the Dow with this expanding wedge. Basically says that we could be trapped in a range for a little while, but if we were to, if the Dow closed any day this week above 31,160, then there's a chance that we could retest the high. And if we start to slide underneath 30,000, we're at 31,000 right now. So if we went down to 30,850, 820, I think we could start a downside consolidation. But what's really fascinating to me is the mix of the different sectors that we've got. It seems to me that fewer and fewer stocks are actually holding the market up at these levels at this particular point. So in a sense, I think there's some kind of distribution going on. But I think there's also that rotation. We've been talking about for some time now that I think that many of the very powerful tech stocks that were leading have kind of stalled, like the Amazons, et cetera, Facebook, just kind of stalled at the high level. And as long as they're taking a breather, that kind of slows down the momentum there. But other stocks, and what's fascinating, for years now what we've seen is that when one sector starts to get a little tired and just needs a breather, another sector comes along, which is one of the reasons why we've been long the IWM as well as the Dow, actually, but the IWM for quite some time. And here we are, IWM, the Russell 2000, didn't make an all-time high today, did yesterday. It's done very well, and that was the sector that kind of took over for a while. So I suspect that we're about to go into something very similar, that some of the sectors, for instance, the biotech sector has been on fire, especially the little stocks. So they might go a little longer, and then they're going to have some time out because they'll be overbought. So I think what we're looking at is this rotation is very, very important. So for subscribers to my opening call, for some time now, I've been focusing on really low-priced stocks, single-digit stocks that look very good, that have been beaten down, that have the potential to not just have a quick move to the upside, but then to sustain that move. I don't know if this is going to work, but I just wanted to show you some of the techniques you spoke about, the webinars that I have.
Yes.
But here's a stock. Let me just drag this across right here. For today, I showed this stock here. KDMN is a symbol, Cadman Holdings, and they're in the biopharma area. So I love this chart, the way it broke out, and I said, okay, this stock right now is trading at about $5.30-something. It's higher than I wanted. Overnight, it's had a bid that made it higher, but we want to buy it underneath 514 today. Sometimes I give it time, but today I just knew that if it pulled back, there was a good chance with this cup formation that this breakout could occur. So we were very lucky. It gapped up, and then it started to move down, and finally it dipped under $5.14. So we got it at 5.13. The low was $5.11. And just a moment ago, it was trading at $5.40. It's trading at 5.37. So what I like about these is there's the pattern that I showed for subscribers. They're looking at this cup formation. They're looking at what I call a Chapman wave inside wedge target repellent line. I show where we're taking it from and where it's going to. And then I show the left side, right side price time match, where if you're able to pick the fulcrum at the bottom, in this case going from 550 back in June at a peak D, we're always looking at that fourth highest peak, and then all the way down to 315. And that was in, I missed the date. I should have put that date in. The date was right there. And that was the week of the 6th of November. Then if you use the same time sequence, you've got a good few weeks to try to get back to that 550 level. Well, lo and behold, today it went to $5.40. And so it could, in fact, get in leg C in the weekly chart, get to that high that was our target of 626. And what's really important about that is if you're looking at the monthly chart, and this is what I like so much about doing chart formations, that it's really, it's kind of a template for many different time frames. So here we are in the monthly chart, and you can see this thing, if it breaks out above this declining line, which has been declining since 2018, when it was out in the 560, 570 area, look, all of a sudden it's breaking out, and then it's got some fresh, if I squeeze it even more, this monthly chart, look at that. It was an IPO back in July of 2016 at 1173, plunged to 160, and now if it breaks out, if it can get to $6, it's free to expand to the upside. So that's the kind of thing I like a lot.
And folks, it's very easy to get Basil's newsletter. Come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to go into newsletters. You see the opening call right there. You just hit subscribe. Basil, you have a great one. Safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Tom. Have a great day.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. TFNN has developed a daily programming lineup for traders by traders. We start every trading day live at 8:30 a.m. with Tommy O'Brien hosting the morning market kickoff as he starts the day off by breaking down everything you need to know about what's going on for the trading day ahead. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento takes your calls and questions live on the air for the opening bell as he hosts Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the Bull Bear Trading Hour. At 11 a.m., it's Kevin Hinks and Alex Coffey from TD Ameritrade Network with Fast Market. Basil Chapman at noon with the Tiger Technicians Hour. Steve Rhodes hosts the Trader's Edge at 1 p.m. Dave White with the Power Trading Hour at 2 p.m. And Tom O'Brien closes out the day for the final hour of trading live from 3 till 4. Don't miss a second of our daily programming lineup. Tune in to Tiger TV every trading day live at TFNN.com. Educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 56. You get the NASDAQ up 15. S&Ps are up 5.5. Let's just go look inside of the Dow Industrials, looking at the strength versus the weakness out here. Point-wise, what we have out here is that you have 3M is putting 39 positive points in the Dow, Johnson & Johnson 29, Microsoft 26, IBM 23. Taken away from it, American Express minus 28, you get United Health minus 24, Nike minus 15. Let's go over to American Express and just take a look at AXP. So AXP came out with the numbers, came out with the numbers this morning. Oh, now this is going to be dangerous, folks. Okay, so check this out. So American Express came out with numbers this morning. Bottom line, market's selling it off. That being said, guess what? You have volume on the sell-off. you have a monster gap. Now, this is where, you know, if you're new to gaps in general, folks, this is something you just want to keep an eye on. You don't have to trade this, baby. But this is what normally happens with a gap. We gapped up, okay, on the 6th of November. So let's see. Yeah, so more than likely that's going to be the last earnings. We went from 96. Oh, no, it was Election Day. Like, we went from 96 bottom up to 113, 119. You eventually get all the way up 5 days ago till the high, which is out there at the 129. Now, we had pulled back down. Most of the time, when you come back down, you get to the top of the gap. The top of the gap here is about 110. Then you get a little bounce, and then you're going to close that whole gap. But in particular, when you are coming off highs with volume, which this is, you know, we had made highs with 4 million shares. You came off with 6 million shares. Today you're already doing 7 million shares. So that is a heads up big time with American Express. And let's see what they're... I have to bring this back a bit, but... So their estimated revenue is $9.4 billion. They did $9.35. Let's see. They included $674 million in a reserve release. That's what the banks had done also. Okay, so they don't think they're going to lose as much money as they thought in the March area. The CEO is saying that card spending has continued to recover. Fourth quarter write-off rates, some of the lowest in a few years. Yeah, bottom line is that the market's shooting it down. And I expect that, guess what, the way that is trading out there, that thing wants to go finish off the gap. NDX 100, now this has been the, this is the mover in the marketplace, period. Today what you have Fox up 8.9%. That's got firepower under it. Sirius Satellite's up 5%. Moderna's up 3.1%. Taken away from it, Peloton. Peloton's down 5% or $8. You got Mercado Libre off 4.9%. You get DocuSign down 4%. And you get Zoom off 4% also. So let's go see what's going on with Fox over here. So Fox, they come up with their numbers on the 9th. Oh, I see. Okay, so hey, the bottom line is that there's really no big news. Okay, you know, the bottom line is that Fox, of course, does have the playoffs, and they got to pop up in the playoffs. No doubt about that. And you know, we'll see where that whole there's no doubt. Let's see. Yeah, Super Bowls are 2 weeks. I'm not sure whether it's on Fox or what channel it's on, but you know, Fox has a lot of sports, and they're getting those playoffs gave them definitely plenty of commercial space. King Dollar. Let's go take a look at King Dollar, because we have a King Dollar out here. This has been hanging out, and it actually, the last couple days, folks, we went sideways, okay? That being said, it was like, you know, I was looking at this saying, hey, man, you're going to try to make a run again. So it tried to make a run today. Now, this setup here, well, first off, I'm a bear in King Dollar, okay? And what you have here is that we got up to the price point today of 90.613, gave it up. We're at 91.56. So that's saying, once again, that you're going to basically get down to the lower end of this consolidation. And things are definitely set up for the Federal Reserve tomorrow. So here's a couple of the different scenarios that the market is basically, well, this I'm talking about now, the note and bond market. The note and bond market, when we came down fast and furious, it was 5 days that we came down, and I'm going to put the 10-year up, and you can see how this laid out. Okay, so we came down starting the 8th of February, 5 days straight. We started out on a 10-year of 138. We got down to 136. Now, when we did that, you know, you had plenty of folks coming out saying, this is it, you know, rates are going to be going up, that's it, you know, we hit the bottom here. And depending on how long you've been in the marketplace, folks, the note and bond market has basically, I'm trying to find the right word here, it's not tricked, fooled, traders and investors for a good 10 years right now, okay? Bottom line is that, you know, technically, what we had done, and this is what's really cool about technicals. Technically, all as we did, I'm going to put this up now, a continuous contract so you can see this, is that TY generic, here we go. Okay. So when I bring this back, what you're going to see is that the bond market came back to its breakout area, didn't even make it to the bottom of the breakout area. The bottom of the breakout area is 134.15. We got to 136.01. So it comes back into that area. It rejects lower price. And now you're going topside again. You know, so it's a classic. You break out. In this case, we stayed up there 7, 8, 9 months. You pull back. And my point being that the Federal Reserve flat out has told us that they're going to continue buying $120 billion worth of bonds a month. The real kicker is that how do they tell the marketplace that now they're not going to pull back a bit? The last statement that came out of there flat out was that they're not only going to do it, but they're going to give the market plenty of time to get ready when they stop. Now, if you can figure that one out, folks, it's going to be really cool, because I can't, and the market is basically looking at that saying, okay, so let's say if they're going to stop in a year and a half, like, do they come out a year from now saying, hey, in 6 months, we're going to stop? Well, they might as well stop right then and there, because the market's going to take conniptions upside down when this happens. So what is the take? My take, folks, guess what? Not going to stop for a long time. Not quite sure how it's going to happen, but they're just not going to pull the rug. It's not going to happen. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. Bio biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Directions Daily S&P Biotech 3x Bull and Bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now up 3. NASDAQ is down 3. S&Ps are down 1.5. And we get the next equity here that is flying, folks, okay? This is going to be quite a year out here. There is no doubt. This one here, they had an article in Seeking Alpha and bottom line. This is an intraday run, and this is quite a run. Same characteristics, though. You know, the bottom line is you get a 13% short position in it. You get a float out there of 169 million shares. This is Pitney Bowes. And what ends up happening, let's see when this come out. You're going to have, there's going to be a lot of sites just hankering that, you know, you load up on something, you get a article out there and see if you can get any spin. So this one here started out at 12:30 this afternoon, folks. This was trading at $7.34 up until 12:30. And then bottom line, explosion topside, you know, and we'll see where the rest of this shakes out. Let's go to Freeport Mac Moran, one of the tigers taking a look at a Freeport Mac Moran. The low here is $4.82 for the year. The high is 32. It's trading 27.11. Now this had made a really sweet run. You go back 3 months ago when the stock's at $16, made that run all the way up to 32. And I would definitely wait until at least the breakout area. So the breakout area on this is 24. You're at 27. And if you get too much, if there's too much volume at 24, then it's going to be all the way down at that 21, 29 area. That's how this baby's set up. Put this on a weekly. Yeah, see, this is, I mean, when you put this on a weekly basis, you can see this stock actually took off from $4.82. So be careful where you're going to pick a spot in here, because the fact of the matter is that you could have a 0.382 retracement of that move, and it would be pretty intense. Let's go take a look at the copper market, since we were looking at Freeport Mac Moran, because that's a monster copper stock. You're still at 362, and yeah, this still wants all-time highs, which is a big deal, man. That's how this is shaking out. You're at 362. I believe the all-time high in copper is up there at approximately the 440 area. And that's the way that is shaking out. So XAUHUI inside the gold market. We have flat markets out here. You know, the XAU is down 81 cents. Let's just see what we got with volume out here yesterday. Okay, that's good. Yeah, you got a little uptick in volume yesterday. So we had made a low out here on Friday with 29 million. You go topside yesterday with 32. That's what you're looking for. I suspect the gold bugs index is going to be the same, but let's take a look at that gold bugs index. And what you're looking for, folks, when you're looking for volume, you're looking for consistency. Meaning if you're looking for a stock to go up, you're looking for pullbacks with light volume. As it starts crawling up, you're looking for expansion of volume. I mean, quick, too. Same setup here. This is cool. So on the gold bugs index, same thing. Friday, you made a low out here with 18 million. Yesterday, you do 19.5. You're going sideways up here. That still indicates that higher prices are coming at us. Now, it's going to get really interesting. And the Fed statement tomorrow. No doubt about that. Now, when I look at the euro is trading 121. That thing wants to go for its highs again. We rejected lower price out here today. It's in a positive position. We go to the pound. We take a look at the pound. Pound's at 137. The pound is stronger than the euro, by the way. Oh, this could be interesting to see what happens with the pound, man. The pound rejected a lower price out here today, too. But what the pound does have, if you're into candlestick charting, this is a last engulfing. Interesting. So what a last engulfing is, folks, oh, no, it's not. Nope. That's good. Okay, that's real good that it's not. The wick is too small. No, so the pound, we're at 137. That wants to run to 141. And something that you want to keep your eye on overnight is this, folks, is that the Hang Seng, okay, had broken out in a monster way. What happened is that last night, you know, it broke out 2 days ago, and it was a nice breakout. No, actually, not 2 days ago. Well, yeah, yesterday it broke topside again. It actually broke out five days ago. Now, that being said, what ended up happening, this thing got hit in an extraordinary way last night. In fact, all of Asia did. So you want to keep your eye on that, because if this thing, the Hong Kong right now, we're 29,391, 28,864 would be the number. If that gets back inside of that, that very well could say, hey, guess what, man? The bottom line, you're going to have a failure. And then you can start looking at our own markets. Let's go to Dave in Boston. Hey, Dave, what's going on?
Good afternoon, Tom. How you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
Well, I'm an oil guy in Boston in January, and I'm watching ExxonMobil go down. It doesn't seem to make a lot of sense, but tell me, it looks like it's in a C to D leg down to, like, the lower 45s. Can you help me with that?
Yeah, so let's do, I'm going to put this on a weekly, all right? Just so to take it, okay, so if I get it on a weekly, let's do this first. It's on a weekly, it's on an ABC up. Okay, let's see what that's at. That's at 44, it's a big one. 13, 1 second, that's 53. Oh, I see. Okay, so if you want to see something, so this finished its ABC structure on the way up. That's what happened here, okay? Missed it by 2 points, but it finished its ABC on the way up on a weekly. Now what you have is that, okay, so you failed today. It's not that bad. Well, I mean, your first leg down is like 41. You know, what happens here, Dave, is this. You can kind of expect this, unfortunately, because of the fact this was the first run that Exxon had in years. I mean, I know you know that, right? Do you know what I'm saying? You know, it's been going down forever. So,
yeah.
You know, when you do a first run like that, the first run, it started at 31, gets all the way up to 51. That, you know, percentage-wise, that's a big number, right?
Right,
so
right.
Percentage-wise, also, you can get quite a pullback, man. I mean, this, you know, 41 is game here.
All right.
Yeah.
Tom, do you look at this? I know rig is in the topic. It might be out of the league as far as what ExxonMobil is, but I know I've heard you with, like, I know you're in the building, and I'm in the HVAC and solar. Do you think that ExxonMobil could be facing the likes of a rig or
no.
something along those lines?
No. No. So no. Rig, folks, is Transocean. Rig is, they specialize in deep water drilling, okay? No, Exxon's no. No. So picture this. Over the course of years, yes, we're going to use a lot less oil, right? We might use more oil because there'll be more people, okay? But I think what would end up happening, Dave, is that there's not going to be other big oil companies that are getting in business. You see what I'm saying? So,
all right,
they're going to be there. I mean, it was a 6-year deal on the way down. It doesn't mean it's ExxonMobil is certainly not like ExxonMobil when we were growing up. That's for sure.
Okay? Right, right.
But the bottom line, as an investment, they're still paying, what are they? They're paying 7.5% right now. So,
yeah.
You know, I
was short them, and I'm just kind of ever since the new administration, I'm looking at it like this does. It almost seems like a doomsday delivery, but I'm just trying to get your take with the solar. I mean, HVAC, and there's a lot of ways of using just electric.
No, I agree. And, my take there is that it's not going to be. You know what it's like. So picture this: administrations can't do anything when you have huge swings. It was just like Trump wanted to bring the coal business back, right? Well, coal business is out of business. Going to be out of business forever. Okay, what is going to and still keeps hitting, you know, the oil business is the electrification and the harnessing of the electrification in society, for sure.
Right.
I mean, I suspect it's, I don't know if it's going to be 20 years or 30 years. I mean, why does it even have to be wiring? Someone's going to figure that out. Well, we don't even need wiring.
Right.
This is going to be, you know, I know that sounds bizarre, folks, but guess what?
No, I know.
You know, my take is that that's going to happen. I mean, just look at, your hair goes up in the air. You're in Boston, right? Yeah, it's perfect.
Right.
He's in Boston. So picture, folks, what happens in Boston, right? And it's probably February, but the bottom line, you're cruising outside. Your hair is, like, up in the air because, like, the temperature has gone, right? I mean, when you're a kid, you know, the different temperatures.
Touch everything and get electric shock.
Yeah.
Electric shock.
Yeah, so... And
well,
then solar, you know, down here, Dave, we have the electric companies are fighting like crazy, man, that individuals don't really get into the solar business. But you can see why, because we have so much sun. I mean, it's like,
right.
We shouldn't be paying for anything down here. And our electric bills are huge, folks. Huge.
Are
okay.
They?
Yeah.
You know. Oh, really? I mean, it seems like this is what they want to do. It's, you know, a while before they have sort of a clear run with it, and just how much can they sort of take away from, and they're doing it with natural gas as well.
Yeah, I mean,
so,
it's going to be the community by community will end up winning, I think, on a longer basis. You know, as soon as people, you hook a couple, I hooked a couple solar panels, you know, I didn't do it personally, but the bottom line, into the pool, I mean, it's a joke, you know. The bottom line is that, you know, you don't have to heat your pool in the winter, man. It's like,
right.
And that's
right.
Only two panels, folks. Okay. It's like,
yeah,
you know, so.
Well, we've got the cars now, the homes are getting wired up and,
yeah.
You know, slowly but surely you're seeing the, you know, the slow demise. I mean, whether it'll ever go away, I doubt it, but.
No, I do too. You know. You get
kind of the take of it.
Yeah, for sure, man. Cooking, brother.
Tom, thanks for your time.
Nice talking to you, man. Have a great one, man.
Nice.
Have a safe one.
I know.
Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We have the Dow Industrials right now down 17. NASDAQ off 14. S&P's off 5.5. Oh, no. Oh, sorry about that. Oh, you know what happened? I was just looking at the second clock, folks. I can hear the producer saying, what? What are you doing, Tom? hey, let's go and take a look at U.S. Steel. That had been on a run also. Same type of setup, meaning big run. You're getting a decent pullback here. And on U.S. Steel cases, now, see, this is cool. Even when we were just talking about, Kenneth, we were talking about Freeport-McMoRan. Keep an eye on U.S. Steel simultaneously, because U.S. Steel is ahead of Freeport-McMoRan a bit. It already went into its breakout area. It's below it, which is 1857. You're at 1826. If you see U.S. Steel go a little bit lower, then that gives you a monster heads up on the aspect of where Freeport-McMoRan can go, because these are running together. You know, these are commodity runs. That's how you kind of want to shake these. That's what I actually love about commodity runs. What happens with a commodity run, folks, is that the sector is very small. So the amount of information, okay, that you get out of that sector is really cool. Meaning, there's always like one equity on top of another. And then, of course, you're just not looking at the sector. You're looking at that sector. Then you're looking at the good old U.S. dollar. And then you look at the bonds. Okay? And as you start putting those together, the bottom line is that your probability gets a little bit better, that you'll get an understanding of where that sector wants to trade. What's really cool is just what's happening right now when you get the first big pullback, because now what you're going to find out is that what is stronger and what's leading. And in this particular case, what you have is that, you know, the steel is leading the copper a bit. So if you start seeing the steel breakdown, guess what? It's a big number. It gives you an idea, because you know when you're looking at charts, it always, like, it's kind of the same days where you get the volume. Well, one goes there, that's where the next one's going. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.